might make gets a second one. You want to do whatever you can to get him the third. He found himself in good spots tonight, and we were able to get him the puck. Some great shots that he made on that second goal and third goal, the one timers, world class shots. So he was really good tonight.
You see him again, obviously. What's it like playing this team 3 times a week?
You get to know him pretty well, but I think for us, the important thing is to understand how we got to play against them, what makes us good against them, when do we struggle against them. So, and I'm sure they're going to do the same thing. So, 3 times in a week is always hard.
But your 9 goals in obviously the last 2 games, was something about the region when it has really boosted this team's confidence?
I think for whatever reason, about a week ago, we just hit a little dry spot. We couldn't seem to find the net, and now that's how this game goes. That's every season. We'll have the same conversation where we'll go dry for a week, a little bit, and right now it's going in. So
he had said after the last game that he decided after the Islander game he needed to become a shooter again. Have you noticed that shooting shoot first mentality from the last couple of games?
I think it's been, I've noticed that he's been shooting more the last couple of games, which is great. We all want him to have that scoring confidence, and we know how dangerous he is when he gets hot. And he's got such a good shot that he should be shooting all the time, but I think he's at the same time, he's a really underrated passer too, so I'm sure he'll make the right decisions.
How much of it is also sort of a reflection on the collective effort of your line right now, do you think?
We understand our responsibility, that we need to produce offense, and the last couple of games we've been able to do that, and we've got to keep doing that. That's no secret that our line has to score goals, and we have, it's a good thing, but we have pressure to score goals, and it feels good when you have a night like tonight.
You were aware, of course, that you reached 400 points?
I didn't know until someone told me after the game. Taramina told me, so. I don't know what to say.
It's pretty good.
good number, yeah.
Does it make you feel old?
Keep some more? Yes, it does. I didn't realize I'd been around that long.
Do you feel like you guys made it, you know, much more difficult tonight against them?
Yeah, as I was saying earlier, we did a little bit in the second, but we didn't turn the puck over as much on our breakout or skating through the neutral zone, which is where they get a lot of their offense, and they're a really good transition team, and no offensive team likes to have the puck repeatedly chip behind them, and you have to go fetch it all the time. So I thought that was a big difference for us, so we did that a lot better tonight.
Taramina also tell you that you're only 30 points behind Scott Stevens now, 8th all-time Devils history.
He's 8th? I didn't know he was 8th.
No, he didn't tell me that.
I didn't know that. I think we'll have to wait till next year for that. Maybe not. Who knows? Hopefully not.
You didn't have to try as hard to get COVID the hat trick this time as you did the empty netter last time, right?
No. Again, like I said, when a guy's got two, you do what you can to get him a third. He didn't need the empty netter tonight, so it was good.